welcome back to Comic Flip. Today we're doing another recap review video on Aero number 1. This is the first solo title feature of this character. She originally appears in New Agents of Atlas number 1, which recently came out. It's part of that War of the Realms run. In it, you have your first full appearance of the new team, the New Agents of Atlas. It's a superhero team consisting of heroes from Asian descent. You have Shang-Chi, Jimmy Woo, Amadeus Cho, Crescent, Io, Luna, Snow, Aero, Silk, Swordmaster, and Wave all on this team. So that's definitely a key issue to get. If you haven't already, definitely pick up New Agents of Atlas number 1. So this book came out July 3rd, 2019. The writers are Zhou Liefen and Greg Pak, artist by Keng and Pop Man. The summary is, Catch the Wave, all new ongoing series. The breakout stars of War of the Realms, Agents of Atlas debut in an oversized team-up book. Get ready for the English language debut of the first appearance of Aero, the high-flying Shanghaiese superheroine created for Marvel by Zhou Liefen and Keng. And in a brand new story written by Planet Hulk writer Greg Pak, Aero teams up with Wave, Marvel's newest Filipina superheroine. What strange forces have turned the buildings of Shanghai into monstrous golems? And what is the secret origin of Wave? So, spoiler-free review. The art in this book is beautiful, breathtaking. It's in the style of manga. It's a quick read, which I actually enjoy. The pacing is nice. This book is actually a two-for-one because you have an Aero story, and then you also have the origin of Wave at the end of the book. Definitely worth the pickup. It's a good read and overall good investment if you are interested in flipping this book down the line. Just on the topic of flipping, there is a variant, a ratio variant, a 1 in 50 of Aero number 1 that's currently going for $45 for a high-grade copy. Also, the New Agents of Atlas number 1, there's a variant done by Miko Suoyan. It was limited to 1,000 issues. That is going for $300 for a high grade, and mid grade about $100. So from this point forward, we'll be in spoiler territory, so if you haven't read the book yet, stop what you're doing, go to your local comic book shop, buy the book, read it, then come back, or if you don't want to be spoiled, stop the video here now. Thanks for joining, welcome, and goodbye. Okay, let's jump into it. So, on page 1, a lot gets accomplished. We find out we're going to be in Shanghai for this story. That's the backdrop, the setting where Aero lives. You find out her full name, which is Lei Ling, and you find out that she's an architect who helped build Shanghai. And it's clear that she definitely loves her city. You also learn that she has the power of the wind, in case that wasn't already clear. I feel like the name's kind of a giveaway for that. On page 2, she reiterates that she'll do anything for Shanghai. And then she says, today is a bit strange because I'm usually helping building skyscrapers, and now I'm helping tear them down. So she's in the middle of a fight with this giant rock monster. And she keeps harping on the fact on how beautiful the building was and how it was almost finished, but now it's a monster. And the actual design of the monster is kind of cool. I'll throw up a picture right now. And then on one of the pages she's saying that, you know, she's been playing defense, she's been running air currents throughout the interior, making sure that no one's trapped is inside, which is a nice little nod to her powers. She basically destroys it, and then we have a flashback to months earlier from her studio, which is called Sacred 3 Design Studio. So she's at her desk, you know, making some drawings of future buildings. And then you learn that she's late for dinner, and she has a boyfriend, and then she has an assistant. She gets upset about the rush hour, but she's like, wait a minute, I'm a superhero, I could just fly there. And she does that, and it's pretty cool. It's also pretty cool to see her in her normal clothes, but I definitely get manga vibes from these panels. She falls off the building, and she's explaining that she's not afraid, because it's like flying to her, it's complete joy. And she dreamed of flying every night when she was a girl, and then one day she just actually flew. She doesn't know how, it just happened. And she controlled the flow of air just by... lives and breathes the city, and you have a beautiful shot, a beautiful art rendering of Shanghai. Wherever the wind goes, I go. Then, on an interesting page, you see Stark Industries. She says, I know there are other people out there like me, superheroes. They don't just defend their cities, they defend the whole world, and the whole world knows their names. Maybe someday they'll know mine, but the whole world knows of those heroes' troubles too. They can't lead normal lives. Everyone they love becomes a target. But that's not going to happen to me here in my beautiful city. I'm lighter than air, nothing can touch me. So, from this page we learn that she's an anonymous hero. The antithesis to Tony Stark's Iron Man, which shows up on this page. And I'm sure that's laying groundwork for what's to come in the stories ahead. Then she says, basically outlining everything she has as she's flying through the air, not in costume. She says, career, love, family, I'll have it all right here where I belong. And the next page we learn her boyfriend's name is Zhao Yu. Then it jumps ahead again to the present. And there are more rock monsters showing up. And there's two more. She looks up and she sees these fighter jets heading towards these, like, towers pointing downward. And we learn it's not actually towers pointing downward. It's a living thing. And then it says to be continued. So really fast-paced story, beautiful art. It did a good job of grounding the character. And world building in a very short amount of time. We learn she has a boyfriend, she has an assistant, she's an architect. She's kind of like Tony Stark, but she likes to keep her identity and life private and separate from the superhero stuff. I really enjoyed the art style of the book. It really reminded me of Sailor Moon. And I really enjoyed how fast-paced it was. The second half of the book jumps into Wave's origin story, so I'll talk about that next. So part two focuses on Wave. It's called Origins and Destinies Part 1. So there's a little bubble that says the events of the story take place after War of the Realms, New Agents of Atlas number 4. We see Aero getting rewarded for the events in War of the Realms. We also see Triumph Division. Triumph Division is a Filipino super team which made their first appearance in Invincible Iron Man number 2. And in this team you have St. George, Fighter 1, Anatun, Mighty Mother, The Wishing Man, Great Mongoose, and Red Feather. That's your team for the Triumph Division. The focus is on Aero, and she's kind of questioning, wait, where is Wave? And Triumph Division is like, I thought that she was with you. Then it jumps ahead in time, and Aero has tracked down Wave, whose real name is Pearl Pangan. She's hanging out by the Philippine Sea, 500 miles northeast of Manila. And Wave is upset because she got kicked out of Triumph Division for abandoning her posts. And Arrow's like, what are you kidding me? We'll go tell Jimmy Woo and get this sorted out. And Arrow's like, no, I'm an outcast. I've always been. And she jumps into her backstory. Forgive me for my mispronunciations, but it says Mactan Island, Cebu. So basically, Wave grew up by the beach. She was an excellent swimmer. She was supposed to end up in the Olympics, but she got into a lot of fights. She had to work a job at a fast food joint where a lady from Allentech met up with her and told her that they needed to do some studies and if she would like to make some money, they were experimenting on swimmers. So naturally, since she was a world-class athlete swimmer, she joined up and she was getting paid very well to participate in research trials. Then one day, there's an explosion and these group of people jump in, start wrecking the joint. And this is where Wave learns that she has powers and is able to control water. Then she realizes she's fighting Triumph Division and she's been working with the bad guys all along. She says they took her in, helped me figure out how to use her powers, but they always had an eye on her, I guess because she was an outsider. As Wave is telling Aero her backstory, of course, Red Feather finds them, breaks up the party, and is like, your swords and armor are Triumph Division property, I'm here to collect them. And Aero and Wave are about to fight Red Triumph. So basically they're setting up everything is not black and white. There is gray zone. Sometimes the heroes can be bad guys. It's interesting because they didn't really show how Wave is an outsider. So I guess they're going to dive into that more as they move forward. But the second half of the book was more like a regular comic book. Whereas the first half read more like a manga book. So it's interesting to see them split the two stories in this way with two different styles. So that's it for my recap review of Aero number one. If you liked the video, please let me know in the comments down below. Make sure you smash that like button. I apologize for any audio issues, any mispronunciations. I'll catch you guys in my next video, which will be a haul video on Wednesday/Thursday. And I just found out I'm getting some books back from CGC, so CGC haul number two should be out next weekend. Take care, guys.